What's up, everyone? Coming back with you another 1995 and now video. And so I just released the other one a few days ago with Steve Lacy and Mariah Carey. I didn't want to do Mariah Carey again, so I had to go ahead a few weeks in 1995. Apparently Mariah Carey stayed at number one for a bit. And so the next number one song on the charts was Exhale by Whitney Houston. And that was at the end of November. I went ahead and peeked ahead, and it only stayed there for a week. Mariah Carey and Boyz II Men are back after that. And so I'll look at these two as a comparison of the next two on the charts from that same time period. I haven't heard Unholy by Sam Smith and Kim Petras. I do like Sam Smith quite a bit, so I'm sure I'll end up liking the song. So it'll be like a reaction and comparison. And believe it or not, I know a lot of Whitney Houston songs, love most of them, if not all of them, and I don't remember this one that well. So one thing I find surprising, if you look at this video by Sam Smith was released 3 weeks ago. It has 28 million views already, and this just goes to show you like the power of social media and the internet in today's day and age compared to the 90s, pre-smartphones, pre-everyone having high-speed internet. You know, back then it was dial-up and YouTube wasn't even a thing. So can you imagine if these fantastic and talented stars from the 90s had the same exposure that they have today? But anyway, this was from, again, 95, and it only has 37 million views total. So this one will far surpass it probably in the next week. Anyway, interesting stuff. So I'll give these both a listen. I don't know if I'll listen to them in their entirety. That would make a really long video, especially with commentary. But I'll listen to at least half, maybe more, just to kind of get a feel for the song. So, yeah, with that said, let's check out some Sam Smith, Kim Petras, Unholy.
Sorry, it's a rush, darling.
It's cold.
Have a jacket.
Hopefully my mic wasn't too far away and you could hear me. Got a little cinematic intro. This reminds me of like a 30 Seconds to Mars video. Sam the mechanic. Peaking too bad, but yeah, interesting video. I'm gonna not pause it there. We'll pause it there. Interesting video of a variation from, you know, what I've heard from Sam Smith before. I like it. It's catchy. I really like the song. My initial impression is that it'd be a good song just to like kind of vibe to, you know, and it's not Diamonds. It's not Dancing with a Stranger. It's, you know, completely different vibe, but good in its own way. I'm interested in listening to the rest of it, but it's really long, especially with all the cinematics. So we'll just get to that point on it. And then check out, you know, how does that compare to Exhale? I think this was from a movie, if I recall correctly. Maybe How Stella Got Her Groove Back, something like that. I think I saw it when I was searching. Does it say? I don't remember, but anyway, let's check out, you know, the 95 number one, similar time frame, Whitney Houston. Everyone falls. Oh, she hits immediately. In love sometimes it's wrong, and sometimes it's right. For every win, someone must fail. But there comes a point when we exhale. Oh, maybe the movie was Waiting to Exhale. I mean, it's classic Whitney, beautiful voice. She's not doing those power belting notes, but it's just, her voice was spectacular. Like, truly once in a generation level talent. Very, very good singer. Beautiful woman. It's a shame what happened to her in her later years, but that's not what we're doing today. So, trying to compare these two songs would be like, you know, comparing apples and oranges. Completely different vibes. This is more of a chill, you know, I'm having a glass of wine, cooking maybe. Really good song, but completely different than Sam Smith's, you know. And maybe I should have heard the Kim Petras version. Maybe I'll play just a little bit more of this one just to see where it goes. Maybe like another minute. Let's see where it goes, just to kind of get the full feel. Daddy, daddy, if you want to drop the attic, give me love, give me Fendi, my Balenciaga daddy. You gonna need to bag it up, cause I'm spending on Rodeo. I don't know. I really like it. It's a really groovy song. Very cool beat. I don't know, both completely different. I don't know that I would pick one over the other in this instance. They're both really good in their own right. So I guess it just depends on what vibe you're going for. Ultimately, like, I don't know, really, really good songs by both artists. What do you guys think? Tell me down in the comments, what do you think? Which one would you go for? You kind of agree that it's kind of like different vibe for different situation. I think they both, listening to them, especially comparing Sam Smith to the previous number one from last week, Steve Lacy. Again, no offense intended, but I don't know how that song got to number one. It was not good. And this is light years better. So I can see why this is in the number one spot. And I can see why Whitney knocked off, you know, Mariah Carey for the number one spot, even though she only stayed there for what it looked like a week. Deserved it. It deserved to hit it. She's a superstar. And yeah, so... Well, that's it for this one. So I appreciate you guys tuning in and checking out the video. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share. Trying to get to 1,000 subs. And put some comments down below if you'd like to see any comparisons, maybe that I should do in upcoming videos. And look forward to seeing you soon. Peace.